I loaded a Beretta 9mm, I put it up to my temple, and I pulled the trigger. And the greatest peace that I felt was when that hammer fell, because I knew it was going to be over. It was only a microsecond. But when you spend day in and day out suffering, a microsecond of peace is an eternity. Since I'm sitting here, you obviously know that the gun didn't go off. That happened twice. Different ammunition. I tried to overdose once, and twice I tried to slip my wrists.
In America, around 22 military veterans kill themselves every day. John served in Iraq during the Second Gulf War. His experience has left him with post-traumatic stress disorder, or PTSD. The mental suffering has been so great that he was suicidal for 8 years.
One of the things we never realized was that a lot of us would be asked to give our life for our country, not in Iraq, not in Afghanistan, but far, far from the battlefield, at home, alone in the dark. Combat takes an emotional toll. Not only the things you see, not only the things you do, but the base I was on got mortared thousands of times in a year. There's guys on my base that never went outside the wire that are suffering from extreme PTSD just from the constant fear of raining bombs.
An estimated 8 million Americans suffer with PTSD, and war veterans are only a fraction of this number. It's a public health disaster costing billions of dollars to treat. There are treatments available, but the drugs prescribed are only successful in 20% of cases. For those who don't respond to the available treatment, there may be an alternative. MDMA, the active ingredient in the party drug ecstasy, is being touted as a miracle cure for PTSD. The FDA has labelled MDMA a breakthrough treatment, and tests of the drug show that it's highly effective. In a recent study, over 60% of patients no longer met the clinical criteria for PTSD after the MDMA treatment. For John, conventional treatments hadn't worked. He saw the trial as his last hope.
I'd never taken any psychedelics. I'd never taken MDMA. I kind of thought it was going to be like the Matrix, where instantly things were going to get magical.
Is it like gradual rise and gradual fall?
Usually it's waves where you start to notice something. Sometimes people report a lot of thoughts.
And then it kicked in after about 30, 40 minutes.
No anxiety. Geometric patterns.
And I remember thinking to myself, I completely get why people take this now.
For John, the treatment was a revelation.
It was probably the greatest therapeutic experience I have ever had in my entire life.
What are you experiencing?
It disconnects the amygdala, that fear response in the brain, that fight or flight. And you can talk about the trauma without having a panic attack.
Thinking a lot about here's one of my guys.
In Iraq.
Mm-hmm. He lost his leg. Part of him getting hurt was my fault.
The MDMA puts the brain in a place where the therapy can work. And people always ask, describe it. The best description I've come up with is it's like doing therapy while being hugged by everyone who loves you in a bathtub full of puppies licking your face.
MDMA was used in psychotherapy in the 1970s, but became popular as a party drug in the 1980s and was made illegal. It wasn't until the early 2000s that the drug began scientific testing in America to treat PTSD. Testing is now at the final stage of FDA approval, where around 300 subjects will participate. If this is successful, then the drug could become a medicine. Rick Doblin has been at the forefront of this research since the 1980s.
And one of the veterans that was in our study was John Lubecki. He served 12 years in the U.S.
We give MDMA only 3 times, 1 month apart, with 12 90-minute non-drug psychotherapy sessions, and each of the sessions last 8 hours. The current treatments for PTSD flatten out people's emotions, and they're requiring people to take these drugs every day for months or years or a lifetime, basically.
An estimated 20% of former military personnel suffer with PTSD in America alone. The Department of Veteran Affairs spends about $400 million annually on treating PTSD and other mental health conditions. When you take MDMA, it floods the brain with hormones and neurotransmitters that evoke feelings of trust and well-being. Researchers say this allows patients to re-examine traumatic memories.
Think of all the bad shit in Iraq, the worst things can happen.
Like any drug, MDMA has side effects, and there's a moderate risk of addiction, but it is less harmful than alcohol or tobacco. A small non-profit is funding the trial, as MDMA is not patentable, so big pharmaceutical companies have steered clear of the treatment, as it will not make them money. For sufferers of PTSD, this new treatment could be a lifesaver.
If I hadn't have gone through this, I'd be in Arlington Cemetery. I have a stepson. And if it weren't for this treatment, probably would have been handed the flag off my casket. And somebody would have had to explain to him why. Especially knowing that treatments are available. They made it so that my stepson will get the flag off my casket when he's old and gray, and I'm old and gray, and after I've watched him fall in love and graduate high school, college, get married, bounce a grandchild on my knee. Those are the things that this treatment provides for veterans and everyone, rather than a life cut short.